class. As you know, here at Luther Vandross Preparatory Academy, we love diverse perspectives. Last week at Career Day, we heard from a firewoman, and today, we're gonna meet a real doctor.
Yes. I want to be a doctor.
Well, all you have to do is say it, like I did. Excuse me, Queen. I'm Dr. Hadassah Olayinka, Ali Yeoman, pre-PhD. Assalamu alaikum, young kings and queens.
Say good morning, children.
Good morning.
Good morning. Who's in mourning? See, the white man will have you speaking death into the top of your day, trying to kill your dreams just like they killed UPN. Write it down.
Sweetie, you don't need to take notes on this.
You need to take notes on this. It's black history. You know UPN, kids? One-on-one? Girlfriends? Cuts? Eve? All of us. Half and half. Nothing? Veronica Mars. You better not.
I'm sorry, they're all nine. So, no.
Better living through television.
Okay, got the idea.
Cable is America's choice. Better living through television. Cable is America's choice.
Okay, got the idea. All right, now let's concentrate.
How did I fail Dr. Hadassah that way?
What? What's a failure?
Last week, I failed to mention season three of A Black Lady Sketch Show.
Oh!
Only one of my favorite fucking shows, and I totally blew it off. It was on my list for the morning zoo, and I just somehow it got omitted.
Your black card has been taken away.
Oh, man.
It has been...
I barely had one, so yeah.
Well... There was a shade of brown involved. So.
Yeah. So So Black Lady Sketch Show premiered season three on last Friday.
Yeah.
And it was fucking funny as ever.
Oh.
On HBO, HBO Max.
HBO Max is the way to go these days.
Absolutely. Yeah. This is a TV10 podcast episode 03402. I had to think about it for a second.
That means that you've been pre-gaming, sir.
No, not at all.
That would mean 430. Actually, is it 403 or I think it's 402, man. It's 0402, 402 episodes that we've been doing this sucker. And
I'm already getting ahead of myself.
There. It's okay. It's all right. What that basically means, that's what fans can really look forward to from our podcast.
Yeah. By the way, fans, before we get to the sponsors here, the t-shirts are here.
Yes.
They have arrived. We've already had a couple of inquiries, and Tommy Milagro will be hunting you down and getting you shirted. He'll come to your house and aim a t-shirt gun at your face.
I forgot to mention, after we got out of the green room, I don't have my license for the t-shirt gun. You have to have a permit carry for that shit.
Oh, come on.
I looked it up.
This is Utah. You don't need a permit to carry any kind of weapon.
And yet, this is Utah. They are going to deal with some heinous fuckery most foul
okay.
when it comes to doing something fun.
Yeah. Anyway, if you haven't already, email tvtanpodcast@gmail.com. Some of you already have.
Mm-hmm.
Duly noted.
We see you, Justin Barlow. We also see you, Dr. White. Oh, yes. And we don't need to worry about Melissa Merlot. She'll be stopping by next week.
Okay.
Spoiler.
Yeah. There's also Ted.
Oh, yeah. That's right. And that's what I'm pulling up right now in our... listener bags here.
Anyway, our sponsors for the week are Sugar House Distillery. I am drinking the...
That's their can series there. That's the Raspberry Whiskey Sour.
Very tangy.
That is the only way to spend a summer slash spring...
Spring,
slash...
whatever we're in right now.
Yeah, one of those things. And I stopped by at our good friend Ivy at Boustique and decided... to take a gander at their zero alcohol products.
You're taking a walk on the mild side here?
I am taking a walk on the mild side.
Oh,
seriously, Rudy, Reed, no, don't do that. But yeah, no, they are selling, this is the brand, it's called Mondays Zero Alcohol. This is the zero alcohol whiskey I have. They also have the gin over at Boustique.
Weird.
Yeah, and you want me to read the labels
well,
here?
Well, if you can. It's pretty artsy.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to read.
This is some fancy as fuck shit right here. So on the label, a cultural shift is underway.
Oh, no.
A mindset towards self-care, staying sharp, and living life without compromise. A movement that refuses to choose between good health and good taste. Whether you don't drink alcohol or just sober curious, I never was, Monday is here to help you cheers with delicious drinks. So
non-alcoholic whiskey.
Yeah, but it's probably best if you do this as a mix. So
what would you mix this with?
Well, funny thing, because since I was in Booze Tea.
Do you mix it with whiskey?
No, 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 no. Okay. I want to be very good to myself.
Right.
But they did have some nice stuff that, well, they do have some nice stuff there to mix it with, like some simple syrup and some specialty orange bitters. So I just did this as an old fashioned. And
all right.
The one thing you will notice is that it doesn't have the sting of whiskey and bad decisions.
Okay. You know,
like you usually do when you have whiskey.
Right, okay.
But
and Booze Take is the only place you can get this stuff, right?
As of right now, this is the only place. So please stop by there and tell her TV Tam Podcast sent you.
Yeah, if you're a sober curious person, I can't imagine why you'd be listening to this, but yeah. All right.
You're drunk enough listening to this already.
Yep, yep.
And that's before we even got to the sports page.
Yeah, we'll get to that in a second. As far as stuff coming up this week, sad news today, April 11th, day this episode drops, Monday. What? It was supposed to be the season 2 premiere of Chad on TBS.
What?
Got bumped to TBA summer.
Why?
Do not know. It just happened late last week.
America hates brown people? Something, is that what it is?
Probably, yeah. That's probably part of it.
I'm going to say yes, that's exactly what it is.
So Nassim Pedrad's Chad will not be back until sometime in the summer on TBS.
Okay, well, that means we're going to have to champion that a little bit harder.
No explanations given.
Okay.
All right. Also on Monday, this is premiering. It's on Vice, if you get that channel. It's a new docuseries called True Believers.
Again?
It's basically how you get cults and cult leaders.
I thought it was called Being a Republican.
Yeah, there's, I don't know if the Republicans are mentioned in here, but, you know, your gurus and your prophets and your self-styled gods of whatever. But, yeah, Republican Party probably could be thrown in there as well.
Do we have any cult members in our fan base? I'm just saying. I mean, we're basically underground.
Yes.
We tell people to listen to us harder.
Uh-huh.
And we're the only voice that matters when it comes to TV.
True. We might be a cult.
Can we get non-tax status for
I'll
this?
I'll look into it.
All right.
I'll look into it.
Okay.
And that's a Monday on Vice.
All right.
Tuesday, new comedy docu, sort of a Office style docu-series.
Okay.
Mockumentary is what the word I was looking for.
Not a docudrama, a mockumentary.
Mockumentary called Hard Sell with a C, sell. This is about behind the scenes at a women's prison.
Oh.
And this is created by, directed by, and starring Catherine Tate, whom you might remember as Nellie from The Office.
Okay.
Yeah. Redhead, British redhead.
Yes, I remember. Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, her.
Yeah.
The drunk one.
Yeah, she's the warden of this women's prison.
In other words, our spirit animal.
Yeah, so
okay.
She comes from the world of events planning, of course, so somehow she ended up as a warden at a women's prison.
This tracks.
Yeah, and wackiness ensues.
Okay,
Just imagine The Office behind bars with Nelly.
Here's my question.
Uh-huh.
What in the name of Orange is the New Black did somebody think this would sell?
I don't know. I'm interested.
All right.
This is on Netflix on Tuesday.
Oh, okay. That's why it went through. So
yeah,
all right.
Netflix, they'll run anything
except us.
Yeah, well,
need to pitch harder? Is that what it is?
It's phrasing. Yeah. Thursday, Craig Robinson has a new series on Peacock.
Okay. I have been seeing this lately.
It's called Killing It. Coincidentally, also sort of prison related. He plays a prison guard.
Mm-hmm.
Who needs some cash. He needs to buy some land to build a home so he can keep custody of his young daughter.
Like you do.
Somehow that all works out, yeah. And so he finds out about how the city will pay. There's a contest to kill snakes. Snake killing contest.
Wait a minute.
Prize money, $20,000.
Isn't this a Simpsons episode?
Yeah, I think it is.
I
yeah. Yeah, it
okay.
is.
Okay.
It totally was. Simpsons did it. Yeah.
And all of a sudden, I feel like my inner Sideshow Bob going, and of course, this has been produced by the laziest Hollywood hack on their Mac PowerBook.
Yes.
I'm hauling ass to Lollapalooza.
Yeah, so if you don't like snakes, maybe you don't want to watch this.
Hmm. Or if you're a snake lover, probably
also probably traumatic because you'll be seeing the killing of snakes.
And this is not bad for me.
So I don't know who this is for. Friday,
all right.
David E. Kelly is back.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a legal thriller.
Of course it is.
Called Anatomy of a Scandal. As you can probably tell by the title, it's British.
Yeah, it is.
It's a psychological thriller about the upper crust society of British politics. Starring people like Sienna Miller, mm-hmm. Rupert Friend, okay. Michelle Dockery.
Oh, so posh, isn't
it? All so posh. And the director is S.J. Clarkson, who worked on Succession and Dexter.
Okay.
So,
right.
Sounds like it could be good.
Now, is it more proper English, or is it right Cockney slang going on?
I'm guessing more proper.
All right. Okay. So we'll be a little bit more posh then.
Yeah.
All right.
Also, a new anthology series from the people behind Glow have a new, it's on Apple TV Plus called Roar. It's about 6 episodes long, and each episode tells a different story of basically women trying to live in the fuckery of a man's world.
Okay, and let me guess, Katy Perry's going to be on full blast on this sucker.
God, I hope not. But people who are involved with this, starring... this is the creators of Glow made this. Nicole Kidman,
mm-hmm.
Merritt Weaver, Issa Rae,
mm.
Alison Brie, and Betty Gilpin from Glow.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not Glow.
It's not Glow, but it's close as you're going to get.
You know what? I'm going to accept this because we're feminist as fuck on this show.
Yeah. And also on Friday on the Roku channel. It's a thing.
Yeah.
By the way, there's new episodes of Reno 911 there. The defunded season.
Oh,
Reno 911 defunded.
Oh, seriously? Yes. That's how it's titled?
Yeah.
It's okay, I'm gonna find this now.
This is Swimming with Sharks. You might remember, or maybe not, a pretty dark comedy from 1994 starring Kevin Spacey, RIP, mm-hmm. and Frank Wally, about the dirty underside of Hollywood and how deals get made.
Yeah.
And this is a series remake, reboot, rekindling, reanimation,
refunding,
refried,
rephrased.
Yeah, starring Diane Kruger and Kiernan Shipka from Sabrina.
Oh, okay.
Chilling Adventures of.
Oh, okay, the good one.
Diane Kruger plays a hard-nosed Hollywood studio boss, and Kiernan Shipka plays her intern secretary,
okay,
protege,
right,
who's obsessed with her.
I feel like I've seen this, but yeah, keep
it was
going.
It was called Swimming with Sharks in 1994, the movie.
Yeah. No, no. There's like another show that's kind of have a similar feel to it. But
are you thinking of Damages?
I think that might be it. Yeah. So
anyway,
all right.
That's the Roku channel. Also, if you need some more Yellowstone-like TV shows in your life,
mm-hmm.
I don't know who does.
Somebody.
A lot of goddamn people watch Yellowstone, so there's got to be somebody.
Only for the swearins.
Yeah, here's a new series that's dropping on Prime Video on Friday called Outer Range, okay. Starring Josh Brolin.
Oh, yeah.
As an possibly named Wyoming rancher, Royal Abbott. That's not a name.
God. But is he just crusty as fuck?
Yes, he is.
All right.
But so there's family drama, there's get off my land kind of drama, all the dramas you get with Yellowstone, plus a supernatural twist in that there's suddenly a portal to another world, aliens,
uh-huh.
Hell, who knows, appears on his land.
And they are all appearing on my land, mm-hmm. and I am inevitable.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Easy there, Thanos.
So, yeah, so it's Imogen Poots, Lily Taylor, and Will Patton, surprisingly enough, from Yellowstone, are in this.
I just love the fact that you said Imogen Poots.
Imogen Poots.
It's been so long since I heard that.
It's a fun name to say.
God, yes, it is.
You remember Roadies, right?
Somebody did, yeah. And we do.
Also a movie on the Tubi, or the Tubby, if you will.
No, I like Tubi.
You like it's Tubi? Better. Okay, it's free. So there, you know, this is a movie you can watch for free. So bear that in mind as I describe it.
All right.
It's called Titanic 666.
Okay, I like the title already.
And I just want to say it's about time someone made a movie about the Titanic.
A good one.
Yeah, a good one, yeah.
Yeah.
So this is the maiden voyage of the Titanic 3.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'm buying the bit. I'm buying the premise. Keep and, going.
Of course, in the ultimate good taste, they sail it right over the resting ground of the original Titanic.
Oh.
And instant demonic possession occurs.
Of course it does.
Yeah.
Does Leo DiCaprio make a...
No.
That would have been so awesome.
No, your biggest star here is Annalyn McCord.
Why would I know her?
90210, the reboot.
Oh, that's why. And I don't know her.
no one does.
Okay.
But keep in mind, that's a free movie.
No commercials? Or...
Well, commercials, of course.
Okay.
If you're getting it for free on TV, there's going to be commercials.
I should only...
The only thing you get for free that doesn't have commercials every 10 to 15 minutes is this show.
Yeah. We don't do commercials. Well, no. Except we could. We sponsor.
We could.
Yeah. We could.
We could.
Do we want to?
It sounds dirty, dirty and stinky to me. I don't want to do it.
Will money be involved?
Maybe. Not much. Probably not much.
Okay. We'll think about that later during our next fiscal year.
During next staff meeting.
Yeah.
Would you believe Saturday Night Live hosted and musical guested Lizzo? How you like that?
I like this awesomely.
All right.
This is great.
Last night's Saturday Night Live, I've already forgotten who the... Jake Gyllenhaal was the host. Musical guest Camila Cabello.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Camila Cabello?
Camila Cabello.
Yeah. Anyway, first of all, she managed to find a band and a group of dancers who are all 4 feet tall, just like her. So she didn't look short.
Yeah. Well, she is a tiny little thing.
Yes. And also, she did two musical numbers.
Mm-hmm.
One, both of them featured a guitar player. The second one featured Willow, I believe it was Willow Smith.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Thing is, I didn't hear one fucking guitar going on. I see a guitar player just back there headbanging, playing away. It's like, there's no fucking sound. There's no guitar.
Strange how it got so cold in this studio. Is that
frost a... Frost warning! If you're going to put a guitar on stage, make it audible.
We ask so
there's
little.
There's no reason for some, synthed up pop song to have a guitarist out there standing around inaudible.
Or worse, error guitaring with a guitar.
Yeah, so just don't even bring the fucking band up. Because they're not playing live anyway.
Okay.
Fuck that shit.
Come on now. Just be better, Lorne Michaels. Be better.
As we wait for the XFL to make its debut, we have a new upstart football league, which is actually an old upstart football league in name only.
Okay.
It is the USFL.
I was seeing some reports about that.
The United States Football League premiering on Saturday on Fox, NBC, and Peacock.
Mm.
And there's teams like, the first team going out are the New Jersey Generals versus the Birmingham Stallions.
Okay.
You got to come up with names for these things.
And notice.
At least none of them are racist stereotypes.
This is a nice change of pace. Now, is there any teams from Utah?
No.
I know the answer, but yeah.
Is no. New.
Of course not. We can't be allowed to have nice things. And this happens on a Sunday, right?
Money in the bank. Utah Saints. Come on.
We could do this, but why aren't you?
Yeah. So this will happen mostly on Fox and NBC and also FS1 and USA on cable for about 24 weeks.
Okay, so that's 24 weeks. That's essentially 6 months, folks.
Yeah.
And good luck with that. It's something.
We'll see if they make it 24 weeks.
I'm going to put the money on 4.5.
How many weeks did the XFL go?
Well, to be
fair... Well, some stuff came up.
Yeah.
In 2020.
I want to say... let's see. It started in February, so I'd say before they finally had to stop... Five weeks?
Mm-hmm.
About there, if memory serves. So
yeah.
I don't know.
Also, Sunday, Season 7 spring premiere of Fear the Walking Dead, the one I prefer.
The good one.
The Walking Dead I like,
because
it's just fucking ridiculous anymore. Nuclear Holocaust, come on. Also, a Doctor Who special.
Ooh.
Still got Jodie Whittaker.
For now.
For now, yeah.
Okay.
Doctor Who, Legend of the Sea Devils, who are not a USFL team.
Not yet.
Not yet, no.
Yeah.
Could have had the Seattle Sea Devils, but no.
Let's see, Utah Sea Devils?
Didn't work. We got no water or devils.
We don't have any jazz either. True. And therefore.
Yeah, okay, fine. And also a Showtime miniseries, The First Lady. This is a dramatized retellings of the women behind the power in the White House.
Ooh.
So you got Viola Davis playing Michelle Obama.
Okay.
You know, I don't know how many actresses probably would literally kill for that role. Viola Davis got it. That's great.
Does she have the arms for it?
I don't know, but...
And see,
that's a coveted role, though, to play Michelle Obama.
I'm just saying, it should have been Angela Bassett. Did you see her arms from What's Love Gotta Do It?
Yep.
She was toned,
mm-hmm.
just like our leader's first lady.
Also, you have Eleanor Roosevelt, played by Gillian Anderson.
Ooh.
Betty Ford, played by, who is it? Michelle Pfeiffer. Yeah, I'm trying to read it here. Also, people in here are... You got Aaron Eckhart as Gerald Ford.
Okay.
Kiefer Sutherland as Franklin Roosevelt.
Okay. I'm.
Yeah.
Now, all right. Here's my question. Is it produced by the same dude that did A Drunk History?
No, I wish.
Oh, that missed opportunity.
I wish, but no.
All right.
And also people like Dakota Fanning and Judy Greer are also in here as well.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's on Showtime on Sunday. The First Lady.
Okay.
The First Lady.
Thank you for doing that.
And I'm finishing up the current season of Billions, a show I still don't understand. I've taken to watching it with subtitles, mm-hmm. so I don't miss anything.
Right.
Because they talk pretty fast on Billions.
You have to do the Marvelous Mrs. Maisel rule.
Yeah, there's also a lot of financial talk and a lot of bizarre pop cultural references that just fly right by.
How bizarre are we talking here?
Oh, just bringing up obscure baseball players. And making references to Stephen King's The Dead Zone.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Like
some deep cuts.
Okay, so not the TV show, the book.
The book, or the movies or the TV show or whatever.
Wow.
Yeah, just a lot of shit goes by. And I still don't understand the show, but they just wrapped season 6, the first one without Bobby Axe.
Okay.
Damian Lewis. And the new guy, Corey Stoll, coming in. I don't know. They've already renewed it for another season. I don't know.
Stoll's not doing it for you.
I don't know. He's, I'm going to give it another season, see how he does.
He was a tough swallow in the strain.
Strain with that fucking wig.
Yeah. So maybe this is another strain here.
I'm going to go undercover and shave my head. How come it never grew back?
Because it's part of my acting.
Yes. Yes. Yeah,
something
sure.
like that.
And also, I have not gotten to the final episode of Super Pump, The Battle for Uber.
Okay.
Waiting to see, but Travis Kalanick did make an appearance in the recent episode of We Crashed. So these docuseries are kind of overlapping and referencing each other now.
I watched We Crashed.
Yeah?
And
what do you think?
So I'm definitely invested in it. And I actually want to go and watch Super Pump to kind of see how the worlds collide here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do your, because you've been kind of confused by Jared Leto or is hamming it up.
I'm always confused by Jared Leto.
I have a theory.
Cool.
I figured out what the problem is.
Okay.
Jared Leto is channeling Nicolas Cage.
Really?
So here's the reason why I think this. Because at one time, he acted alongside Nicolas Cage in Lord of War. So, he had to have absorbed some of the caginess.
Okay.
And that's why he kind of goes a little full-on out cagey.
Okay.
That's where I'm thinking where your problem is.
All right.
As for Anna Kendrick?
Anne Hathaway.
Anna Hathaway, sorry. I always get the Annas screwed up there. Sorry.
Different skinny white actresses.
Point taken.
Yeah.
I do like her take on this, and
mm-hmm.
it is definitely shining through how she just sort of evolves to...
into a dickhead just like him.
Yeah. I just can't turn away from it.
Yeah.
Mostly I'm sticking around for Anne Hathaway.
Yeah. So as all we are, but I did watch catch the end of the Dropout, the Elizabeth Holmes story.
Okay.
About Theranos, and yeah, I think they kind of nailed the landing. I think they did it right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. So this could be an Emmy nominee?
For Amanda Seyfried. Seyfried. I'm not going to work anymore. Yeah, I think an Emmy definitely for her.
Okay.
Yeah, very well done. That's a Dropout on Hulu. Mm-hmm. What are you checking out this week?
Oh, well, I've checked out quite a bit this week.
All right.
So not only did I binge through Ted Lasso, honestly, that is the sports show we all need in our lives.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Then I finished up Severance.
Holy fuck.
Again.
Yeah, if there hadn't been if the show had been just a medium hit,
mm-hmm.
and not gotten a second season, that'd be hella frustrating.
The acting and the writing mm-hmm. on this.
Yes.
Is spot on. Never has disassociative identity been so cool or so disturbing.
Yeah.
And then Moon Knight came along.
Yeah. Wow, the second episode of Moon Knight, pretty action-packed.
And again, very, very disassociative.
Yes.
Plus, also, you got a dick moon god. My God. F. Murray Abraham can channel the dickishness.
True, yeah. I remember reading the comic as a kid. I don't remember much about it, but it looks right to me.
Yeah, I did kind of wiki it a little bit, and I went, wow.
A lot of story.
And there was a lot of rewrites and a lot of rehashing the character, so no wonder he's got identity problems.
For a character you've never really heard much about?
Yeah.
It's not one of the major Marvel characters.
This is C+ at best.
There's a lot of story there.
Yeah.
So Disney Plus is where you should check out Moon Knight.
Yeah.
And I know you've been watching some sports, too.
Oh, we've been watching lots of sports, so hit the music.
And sports with Tommy Milagro. Go, team.
From the sports desk of the TV 10 podcast, we deliver to you only the sport of professional wrestling. I have been busy as fuck because I have been writing not only for NWA Power and NWA USA. And
writing about them.
That, too.
You're not scripting them.
Not yet. Then I've been also writing on Major League Wrestling, and recently All Elite Wrestling's Rampage show on Friday, which mm-hmm. you can catch on slamwrestling.net for the recaps. Oh, did you know I have an MBA?
Fine.
You got a pregame for when you have to take out here. So
well, this is game, so.
Either way. I would say read up on all that, but here's the stories that you might have missed here. I think I'm going to start... Yeah, I'm going to start this one. A little bit of serious news. Tammy Sitch, the manager formerly known as Sonny, involved in a fatal car accident.
Oh.
So this was early in the week here. She was involved in a traffic crash fatality on March 25th, according to a report filed by the Ormond Beach Police Department in Florida. And Sitch's vehicle rear-ended a car that had stopped for a traffic light, and in turn, that car crashed into the car in front of it. The driver of the first car, identified as Julian Lassiter of Daytona Beach Shores, was transported to Halifax Health Medical Center, where he was pronounced dead. The driver and the passenger of the third car suffered injuries but did not require hospitalization. But here's where the problem is. Sitch was also transported to the hospital and later released after a search warrant was approved and executed to obtain a sample of her blood because she might have been intoxicated.
Oh, okay.
And this is her third offense involving alcohol.
Okay.
Yeah, it ain't looking good for the 49-year-old. More on that story as it develops here. Also, in the week on NXT... The tag team titles became vacated, and this is because, and again, this is on slamwrestling.net. I didn't write for this because my MBA wouldn't cover this. Mm-hmm. I know, you're already game-gamed as it is. Yes. Here. but basically, the team MSK were forced to relinquish the title since Nash Carter was fired from the WWE, leaving his partner, Wesley, without a partner. Basically, Carter was fired after his wife, Impact Talent Kimberly, posted a picture of him in his youth looking like and saluting like Adolf Hitler. She also posted pictures of what she claimed was physical abuse by Carter. So, you know, social media. That's the only way things get done these days.
Okay.
Again, not much more on that story, but we will follow it as it develops here. And this last, these last two I'm going to do, and mostly I'm doing this one for Melissa Merlot, and you'll see why. The title is...
Well, she doesn't listen to this show.
Yes, she does.
Really?
She does.
How come she didn't find out about Our Flag Means Death from Us instead of some rando on Facebook?
I blame this conspiracy, which ties in nicely to this story.
Okay.
Tony Khan claims online conspiracy against AEW. He's alleging that AEW is being conned. Although he's not naming anyone or any promotion in particular, Khan is saying something is fishy when it comes to online critics of his AEW promotion. And he posted it on Twitter, like you do, and said on Twitter, an independent study has confirmed that much of the staunch anti-AEW online community aren't real individuals. It's a staff running thousands of accounts, plus an army of bots to signal boost them. Look closely. These aren't real people. Who'd pay for such a wildly expensive thing? So,
sort of a Silicon Valley twist here.
Yeah. Khan then challenged others to do their own investigating.
Do your own research.
Yeah, because we know how well that helps.
Do your own research.
So that's for Merlot there. And finally this, we're going to end right here.
I think AEW is doing just fine anyway, right?
Oh, they're doing great. They, in fact, if you read my AEW Rampage on the report on slamwrestling.net, Wheeler, Utah had a, Utah,
right,
had a great match against Jon Moxley, a very bloody affair where he emerged as quite the superstar. So, okay. Definitely check that out. But finally this, and I just love this. This is from the news, TMZ.
Oh yeah, the news.
Yeah. Megan Rapinoe of the... World Cup winning USA women's soccer team,
yep,
or football threatens legal action against The Rock,
huh,
over the new XFL logo.
Oh God.
Yeah. Megan, and again, this is on TMZ. Megan Rapinoe clearly believes Dwayne Johnson jacked her fiance's company logo for his new XFL brand. And now she's demanding the actor change it before lawyers get involved. And
so her company is...
Well,
her boyfriend's company is...
What? Her girlfriend's company.
Of course. What the hell am I thinking?
It's okay. You've been gaming here, so it's gaming. Understandable. Basically, Rapinoe says that the new logo looks a bit too much like Sue Bird's together with the E in the symbol of an X. Together is a company designed to promote equality in the media and highlight the achievement of women in sports, and used a unique X as part of their new logo, which I'm showing to you right now.
I'm looking at it.
Yeah. Okay. And I kind of see her point, because the XFL logo, where it's kind of split in the middle of the X, is similar to the X for together.
Yeah, I don't think this is going to go anywhere.
No, but honestly, if you look at it a certain way, it's pretty almost close to the Under Armour logo as well.
I preferred the old logo.
Well, again, we want to wipe away the stain of failure, so I understand the rebranding here.
Fine.
Either way, just know that it's important to get a brand that's so distinctive from other brands. That is our TV Tan tip of the week. Just the tip, phrasing, because it's sports.
And sports with Tommy Milagro. Go, team. By the way, the design of the new TV Tan podcast logo bears no resemblance whatsoever to AC/DC's 1980 album, Back in Black.
We don't know what
Not
you're talking
about. At all.
This has nothing to do with that. We disassociate with it.
Nothing to see here.
No likeness at all, whatever. But, yeah, we're not going to get in trouble with this, are we?
AC/DC?
Yeah.
Are they still around?
Well, I know Brian Johnson's deaf as a post, so I think we're okay.
He won't hear about it.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah! All right.
Fine.
No, nothing to hear about here.
So we're gonna close it out with some big news here.
Oh yeah,
this just in off the teletype.
Oh.
Better Call Saul, the new season coming up.
Yes.
Next week, I believe. Yeah. Confirm. It's gonna be. Can't remember how many episodes, but it's going to be split into two parts.
Okay.
Like they did with Breaking Bad on AMC.
Oh, fuck.
So you're going to see about 7 episodes up front and another 7 episodes in the summer. Yeah.
Okay.
Just deal with it.
All right. I'll deal with the pain. I'll deal with that somehow.
Bryan Cranston and Aaron Paul will be appearing in the final season of Better Call Saul.
Yay!
Jesse Pinkman and Heisenberg.
Oh, yeah. Bitches!
We're going to have to find a good wig for Aaron Paul, though. He doesn't have quite as much hair as he did back when Breaking Bad started.
Yeah. But does he physically look the same as...
Oh, yeah. He still looks about the same.
Okay. Then I'm... Well, actually, that's not going to be a problem. We just need to get one of those wool caps on him.
His wool caps. His hipster, yeah. Hipster caps.
No, the wool cap. Oh, yes. Just keep your head warm in the hot New Mexico desert. Oh, yes. That will be so good. I'm sorry. I can't do with this anymore.
Yeah. So, of course, the final season of Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul, is where it finally crosses over
into Breaking Bad.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
but not only will we find out what the hell happened to Kim.
Oh, yeah.
Because she's not part of the Breaking Bad world.
She never
even mentioned.
She kind of crosses over into the dark side, so. Yeah.
And also, we'll find out what happened to present day Saul.
Oh, yeah.
Undercover at the Cinnabon on witness relocation.
In the black and white.
In the black and white, yeah.
And just to be clear, they did finish all the episodes, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, only just because of that heart issue that he had on the set.
Yeah, no, he's fine.
Okay, we don't need that to happen in the middle.
No.
Okay.
Everything's filmed, ready to go.
All right, and Vince Gilligan, no reshoots. Just leave our national treasure alone.
Yeah. So, yeah, going to leave it at that for you. I want to thank Sugar House Distillery for the... Raspberry Whiskey Sour.
And let's also thank Boosteak for providing some non-alcoholic drinks like Monday Zero Alcohol Whiskey. Mm-hmm. So,
and our other sponsors.
Why, that would be Outlaw Distillery. Then there's Ogden's Own Distillery, fine purveyors of Madame Paterini Gin, Five Wives, Five Husbands Vodka, the Porter's Fire, and of course the Porter's Peanut Butter Whiskey, our favorite. Why are you saying the whiskey so weird? Why are you putting emphasis on the H? Doesn't matter. The Underground, and of course they have their cans. There's the Porter's Cola.
There's too many to list.
Yeah.
They got a lot of them.
Yeah. And of course Bohemian Brewery, great beer there. No matter which place you go, just step in there. Wearing your TV Tan t-shirt, tell them TV Tan Podcast sent you, and fuck the liquor stores.
Yeah, yeah. So email tvtanpodcast@gmail.com, and you'll get taken care of.
More importantly, if you are going to be asking for the t-shirt, put in the subject line, TV Tan t-shirt. That way it's easy for us to track down.
Because we have so many emails.
Oh, we didn't even get to the listener bags. Sorry about that, Ted. We'll get to you next week here. Sorry, fans that want us to interview for this reality show, Starlet. We'll get to you next week. So many to get through. Oh,
God, we get a lot of those.
We need a secretary, man. So maybe my innie could take care of this.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
What could go wrong?
Yeah, nothing could go wrong with that. All right. Do you have anything else to plug?
Nope, that's all. Good night, America.
And jiggle that handle, and off you fuck to our fine sponsor. It's only me and my TV Tan.
Isn't every book pre-Pulitzer?
Charlotte's Web!
Yes!
Of life!
Well, at least there's still a pig.
You like pigs? Huh? No, 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 my young queen! See, the FDA funds the swine industry to destabilize the black community. Is that what you want? Do you like bacon? Well, bacon breaks down to bacon. Bacon, because they want to cozy up to us. And con, because it's been a conspiracy the whole time. You think it's breakfast, I say it's a travesty.
Oh, fun! Class, isn't it fun to hear new ideas, no matter how strange? Remember our opinion sock? Opinions. If you just have one, it's no fun, right?
A white sock with a pink toe? In a class full of black children?
It's a sock.
It's probably made out of cotton, too.
That's what they make
Lord
socks
Jesus
out of.
You know what? You know what kind of sock I have? No sock!
Yeah,
okay?
You don't have any lotion on either, but...
Because it's white! Yes!
What kind of doctor are you?
Great question, Jacoby.
Pre-PhD. It says it right here.
That's not a thing.
In the writing. Typed it myself.
My dad's a nutritionist. Can't you just teach us about the food pyramid or something?
Okay, that's a child.
You want to learn about pyramids?
The food pyramid.
Chapter 8! Pyramids! And other things white people would rather give aliens credit for